what I'm grateful for. Didn't overestimate. Yes, yes. They always say they are better than everybody else. Talking about you made us, you made them equal to us. You made them equal to us. And if you are better, then tell you something else I noticed about ungrateful folk. They can always get other folk to be ungrateful with them. I wish I had a witness here. Oh yes, people that's not satisfied, that they can always run together with unsatisfied people. Those who are unhappy like to run around with unhappy people. And you know what? When they came to that owner with a grievance, when they came to that owner with a complaint, when they came to that owner with their union leader, they came as a group and they said, not I, but we.
We got a problem with you. Tell you something else I've learned about ungrateful folk. Instead of taking their money and going home, you know what ungrateful people? They seldom say thank you. Oh yes, they seldom say thank you. Ungrateful folk, it don't take much to set them off. Always living their life on a short fuse. Almost hate to say things around. Never know. Yes, they think they care more than their fair share. Sir, I want you to know, you made them equal to us. We bought to work. We bought to work in the burn of the day. We bought to work. We bought to work. We bought to work in the yes, yes. Here we are working in the fields. Here we are getting the work done. I said you couldn't have been doing too much. Because I had to go get you some help. I declare that many of us, after God has blessed us, many of us, after God has made a way for us, many of us, after God has brought us through, many of us, after God has opened doors for us, many of us, after God has put food on our table, many of us, after God has made a way for us, many of us, after God has brought us through, we are still.
I know y'all coming as a group, but I ain't gonna attack y'all all as a group. Let me set one of y'all straight, let the other ones get the message. Verse 13, so he answered
one of them
and says, am I being unfair to you? Am I being unfair? You ready to take me on Judge Judy and sue me for the other money? I want to know whether I've been unfair to you, friend, sweetheart, shit-a-bye, honey. I want to know. Didn't you agree? Notice the text, the latter part of verse 13. Didn't you agree to work for a denarius? You the one that said, I'm okay with that. You the one that said that I'm all right with a day's wages. If you wanted more, you should have asked for more. I tell you what you better do. Verse 14, you better take your pay and go. If this is my money, and if I want to give to the one who was high last, the same as I gave you, don't I have a right? What makes you think you can control my you think you can control was what's mine. This is my stuff. Yes, and I have a right to do with my stuff what I want to do. That's mine. Yes, one day I was here at the church. I was on a telephone call. Somebody came in and he wanted to talk to me. And I said, I'll go ahead and make time for him. And the person on the phone just kept on talking. And I just couldn't get off the phone. You'll meet people like that and just keep on talking. You just can't break in. They gonna keep on talking. So the person that was waiting to see me, they got a little irritated. Started to huff and to blow and to pout, walking around because I just wasn't moving fast enough to get the person off the phone. After a while, I got a little tired. Told the person on the phone to hold on a little bit. Hold on for a moment, put them on mute. Put them on mute. Something like I put church folk on mute. And I don't want them to hear me go ahead. I had to let them know this is my time. Yeah, put on the description between my and time. But this is my time. And the fact that you wasted your time doesn't mean that you need to monopolize my time. And poor planning on your time doesn't constitute an emergency on my time. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. This is my money. And I can do whatever. Are you envious? Are you jealous? Are you mad because I gave somebody else when I gave you? And that because I made a way for somebody else because I came through for somebody else. And let me tell you, I didn't give them for what they needed. I didn't give them for what they deserved. I gave those for what I realized. Mother, I didn't give them for what they deserved. I gave them for what they needed. I gave them what they needed because I'm a generous. I'm a generous man, though. Yes, yes, and I come out of let somebody up in Cornerstone. No. The God that we serve is a generous man. Oh yes, he is a gracious God. Yes, he is a God that's pitiful in mercy. Yeah, one songwriter says, let me tell you how I explain his grace. When I realize where God has brought me from, when I realize where God has brought me through, when I realize how God has made a way for me, the only way I can describe it is amazing grace. Yes, how sweet the sight. Saving a wretch like me. Yes, God, I don't know about nobody else, God, but I'm grateful for all that you've done for me. Yes, God, I know I might have showed up to the vineyard late, but I'm so glad that I got there just in time. Yes, 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 yes. And he said, I want you to know something in God's economy of things. Yes, when you work in God's vineyard, sometimes the last is first, and the first gotta be end up being last. Yes, I might not have came at a young age. Yes, I might have done my dirt out there. Yes, I might not have lived the best that I should. Yes, I've gone places that I should have gone. And I did things that I shouldn't have said. And there may be those that grew up in church, always in the church door on Sunday. But the Bible says God has a way of taking those who have messed up, those who have gone astray, those who people said they weren't amount to anything, those that people have turned their nose up, those who walk these streets at night, those who have shot drugs in their lane. And God has a way of moving them to the front of the line. Somebody let somebody know. You better not judge nobody. Because the good God that I serve gives the impression that some prostitutes are going to be some preachers in there. You better be careful how you judge folk. Because the God that I serve, he can clean up a drug addict. And he can meet the deacons in the house. You better be careful how you judge folk. Because God can take those who are tore up from the floor. And he's able to move them above a missionary. Because God anybody here at the Cornerstone Baptist Church, you ought to be glad because you didn't make it at the 6 o'clock hour. Somebody ought to be glad because you didn't make it at the 9 o'clock hour. Somebody ought to be shown up glad because you didn't make it at the noon hour. Somebody ought to be shown up glad because you didn't make it at the 3 o'clock hour. Is there anybody here? You are shown up glad that I made it at the 11 o'clock hour. I made it here just in time. I made it here just in the nick of time. Yeah, I was tore up from the floor up. I was hard-headed. I lived life the way I wanted to live. And I did things the way that I wanted to do. Yeah, but I'm so glad that the good God that I serve, He never gave up on me. I'm so glad that the good God that I serve allowed me to get on the battlefield for my Lord. I am so glad that the good God that I serve let me be a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm so glad that when others pass me by, the good God that I serve said, "Here I am. I want to use you." And I came to Jesus. I came to Jesus. I came to Jesus just as I was. I was weary, worn, and sad. But I don't know about nobody else. I found in Him a resting place. And He has made me glad. I don't know about nobody else. But when I look at my situation, when I look at my story, I'm not unthankful for what God has done for me. My testimony is, I am grateful for the things that you've done for me. I am grateful for the victories that we have won. I could go on and on. I could go on and on. I could go on and on. I could go on and on about your works, because I'm grateful. I am grateful, Lord, for all you've done. Flowing from my heart, flowing from my heart, all the issues of my heart, it's gratefulness. Every now and then, when you look back over your life, every now and then, when you think about where God has brought you from, every now and then, when you think how God has been a good God, you ought to not complain. You ought to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Is there anybody here that you have a flashback and remember where God has brought you from? Thank you. You healed my body. Thank you. You gave me another chance. Thank you. You brought me a mighty long way. Thank you. You delivered me once again. Thank you. God, you've been so good.